Okay, to start our topic, yung topic po natin ngayon is about forensic photography, which is under po siya sa area ng forensic science. Okay, so to start, let's define the word photography. Sabi dito, based on our references, when we see the word photography, okay, meron po siyang literal definition. So basically, when we say word literal definition, it only talks about the etymology, no? Etymology. Okay, when we see the word etymology naman, it's asking for the origin. Yung mismong origin ng word. Saan ba talaga mismo nagmula yung word na photography? So sabi dito, unang i-consider natin, galing na po siya sa isang Greek word. Okay? Means, Greek word phos or photos means light. Basically, when you are doing photography or when you want to have a photographs, kailangan mo ng ilaw. Okay? Napakalaki ng role ng ilaw. Just imagine yourself na inside a room na completely dark without any source of light. Then try to make a photograph. As you can see, wala kang mabubuong image yan kasi wala ng ilaw. So in photography, napakalaki po ng role ng ilaw. Also, galing po siya sa word na grapho means writing or graphia means to draw. To sum it up or to sum it up, when we see the word photography, it's a process of making an image or writing an image through light or drawing an image with the means of light or with the use of light. Sabi pa dito, the word photography ay unang-unang ginamit daw, okay? By scientist Sir John F.W. Herschel in year 1839. So meaning to say, yung word na photography, it was first coined by Sir John F.W. Herschel. So if you will be asked, who is the first person who coined the word photography? The answer is Sir John F.W. Herschel. In what year? Ito yung sagot. In year 1839. That's the reason, if you will be asked in the board examination, okay, kailan daw po ang birth year, no, birth year of photography, the answer is in year 1839. So again, 1839 is our birth year, no? Birth year of photography. Okay? Birth year of photography, 1839. It was coined by Sir John F.W. Herschel. Okay? So sabi pa dito, it's a method of recording images, okay, with the use of light and a sensitized material. Okay? So when we talk about sensitized material, it talks about our, of course, yung ating film and yung ating photo paper. But this is not yet the time na i-discuss yung film or photo paper. Okay, we will gonna discuss that in a sooner series of our videos on forensic photography. Sabi pa dito, marami nalilito sa difference between photograph and a picture. No, sometimes nababaltad siya and some people thought that they are just the same. So let's define, no, based on our references for the purposes of board examination, ano bang difference ng photograph and a picture? So let's define muna yung word na photograph. Sabi dito, it's a mechanical, okay? It's a mechanical and a chemical result of photography. So bakit po siya mechanical at bakit po siya chemical? Mechanical siya in a means that we are using the camera itself. No, a camera is a product of mechanical. No, it's composed of different mechanisms, no, kaya tayo nakakabuo ng isang photograph. Chemical naman, on the other hand, okay, if you're talking about analog photography, before you can able to produce a certain photograph, kailangan muna siya mag-undergo ng iba't ibang series of chemical process. Okay, so an image, sabi pa dito, an image can only be a product of a photography. So basically, when we say the word photograph, any image, no, na nabubuo with the use of camera or any image na nabubuo with the process of photography is what we call photograph. Okay, so ano naman difference niya sa word na picture? Ang picture kasi, on the other hand, is a generic term. Okay, on all kinds, refers to all kinds of images. Hindi po siya limited or hindi po necessarily na galing po siya sa camera. Any images or any images formed can be considered as a picture. Example, paintings, no? Drawing, sketch, okay? Crayons, etc. So, may nabubuong image, but they are not formed with the use of photograph. Okay, so when we say picture, example niyan, painting ni Mona Lisa, na portrait nyo ng girlfriend boyfriend mo, graduation pictures mo, what else? Sketch ng isang cartographic sketcher, and etc. May nabubuong image na may nabubuong picture, but it's not necessarily nagawa po siya sa camera or photograph. So to make it short, okay, when we say the word photograph, image formed by camera. And when we say the word picture, any form image, not necessarily formed by the camera. On the other hand, ibig sabihin pala nun, photographs can be considered as a picture kasi may nabubuong image. But take note, not all pictures are considered as photograph kasi sabi nga natin, hindi lahat ng picture gawa sa photography. May mga pictures na, or may mga images na nabubuo na hindi naman ginagamitan ng camera. Okay, so that's the difference between the two, photograph and a picture. Okay, ito pa, isang topic na kailangan discuss kasi usually tinatanong siya sa board examination, the difference between the police photography and forensic photography. So let's define this one. Basahin natin yung definition ng police photography. Sabi dito, an art or science which deals with the study of principles of photography, the preparation of photographic evidence, and its application. Ito yung pinaka-keyword natin, no? Its application to police work. Basically, you are studying photography, you are learning the principles of photography, saan ina-apply? Kasi ito yung question dito eh. In order for us to determine if it is police photography or forensic photography, we need to answer first, saan ba siya ina-apply? If the photography is being applied only to your police work, then we call that one as police photography. Bigay tayo example, no? You're a member of a forensic group, no? A PNP crime laboratory, no? You're a police officer and you're specialized in taking photographs. And it so happened na may nangyaring crime scene. So the team, yung grupo ninyo nag-responded. So you, as a police officer, no, you're applying your skills in photography in your own police work. So basically, that's already considered as a police photography only. Okay? Kasi ina-apply mo pala yung skills mo, yung knowledge mo, okay, sa work mo as a police officer. However, on the other hand, when we say the word forensic photography naman, all evidence na nagather natin in the crime scene, okay, all evidence na capture natin sa crime scene, of course, ang purpose niya is for them to become an evidence inside the court, no? Para gamitin as evidence inside the court. Now, basahin natin ibig sabihin ng forensic photography. Sabi dito, an art or science of photographically documenting the crime scene. Okay, so documenting the crime scene. And evidence for the laboratory examination. Ano yung purpose natin dito? Okay, we are now applying our skills in photography for the purposes of court trial. Ibig sabihin, yung photographs na nakuha natin during the product of police photography ay ginagamit na siya for court presentation. Example, as a police officer, no, nagresponde kayo sa isang shooting incident. In the crime scene, may nakita kayo mga slugs, no, mga bala, may mga what you call this, firearm. So you photograph it, no? Because that's your job to photograph the pieces of evidence. After this evidence captured or photographed, of course, dine-develop yan to be presented inside the court, which makes it now a forensic photography. Okay, so to make it short, police photography, ina-apply yung photography sa police work. Forensic photography naman, ina-apply yung photography in court purposes or for administration of justice. Okay? Next topic natin is about yung mga iba't ibang gamit, no? Or iba't ibang uses ng photography. Okay, marami po siya actually, na marami siya. Let's start with, if you will be asked, no, what's the first application of photography in police work? So it is asking for the first application, meaning to say, saan daw unang ginamit ang photography in a police work? We answer for personal identification. So bakit ganun? If you will be asked ba muna, no, what's the first personal identification technique? That's the first question muna, no? Ano ba yung pinakaunang personal identification technique na ginagamit ng kapulisan dati? The answer for that one is no other than the anthropometry system, no, the anthropometry. When we see the word anthropometry, from the word itself, anthro, we need to say, of course, body, no? And when we say the word metry, measurement. Okay, to make it short, when we say the word anthropometry, it's a process of identification of a person based on the measurement of his body, particularly his or her bones. So sabi kasi ni Alphonse Bertillon na father po ng anthropometry, sabi niya na ang bawat tao daw magkakaiba ng sizes ng buto. So since magkakaiba tayo ng sizes ng buto, it can be used as a means of personal identification. O ngayon, paano napasok doon yung photography? After mo kasi sukatan, okay, after mong sukatan ng mga, of course, ng mga ba ng sukat ng mga bones or body mo, you need to be photographed, okay, for us to have a record. No, kailangan mong i-photograph. Okay? And that photography is what we call, ito na, the mugshot. No? It's what we call the mugshot photography. Diyan po nagsimula yung mugshot photography. Diba? We are already familiar what does it mean when we say the word mugshot photography, diba? Yung pag nakakommit ka ng crime, tapos may nahawakan ka ang pangalan, diba? Tapos pangalan mo, yung crime na commit mo, or yung law na na-violate mo, tapos you need to be photographed side by side. Tapos mapansin nyo sa likod, may mga linya-linya. Basically, nagsimula po yung concept na yan sa anthropometry. Okay? So after mong sukatan, i-photograph ka for us to have a certain record. Okay? So yun yung unang gamit ng photography in a police work. Okay? Next, we have for communication purposes. Ano ibig sabihin siya for communication purposes? Ang sabi dito, one of the most universal method of communication. Ibig sabihin, with the use of photography, kaya natin makipag-communicate sa other people even though na magkaiba tayo ng language or magkaiba tayo ng dialect. Now, let's say for example, no, si A, isang Bisaya, si B, isang Ilocano, si C naman, isang Chabacano, let's say for example, no? Tatlo sila, magkakaiba sila ng language or magkakaiba sila ng dialect na ginagamit. If they're going to use their own dialect, of course, hindi sila magkakaintindihan. But try to imagine if we have a certain photograph, no? Photograph na merong puno, no? Merong puno dyan. Tapos ipakita mo yung puno na yan kay A. Ipakita mo yung photograph na yan kay A. Ipakita mo kay yung photograph na yan kay B. At ipakita mo yung photograph na yan kay C. Basically, lahat yan sila, maiintindihan that this photograph is merong puno. Okay? Merong pinapakitang puno. So, that's already considered as communication kasi nagkakaintindihan yung tao, di ba? With the use of photograph. Okay, so yan sila tayo na for most universal method of communication. We can also consider photography as the utmost use in police work. Okay, due to its, ayan, for record purposes. I mean to say, if you will be asked, what is considered to be the utmost use, no, yung pinaka-greatest, yung pinaka-the best na gamit ng photography in police work, of course, for record purposes. And of course, for preservation purposes naman, ginagamit lang po ang for preservation if may mga crime scenes. Okay, to preserve the crime scene or to preserve its physical evidence. Remember, pag may crime scene kasi, of course, kailangan pinaprocess yan. And there are times na nililinis yung crime scene, tinatanggal yung ebidensya. So in order for us to preserve the image or preserve the original situation, yung original na arrangement ng mga evidence, we need to photograph it. Or let's say for example, no, yung patay na tao, syempre nabubulok yung patay, yung bangkay eh, nabubulok yung katawan ng isang tao. So in order for us to preserve the original condition of the body, we need to photograph it. Okay, so we have also, of course, pag nangyari ang crime scene outdoor. So syempre pag nasa outdoor ka, there are tendencies na iba't ibang weather, umuulan, umaaraw, bumabagyo, nagsusnow. So the tendency is that masisira yung crime scene. So in order for us, again, to preserve the original condition, we need to photograph it. Again, ang purpose ng preservation is for us to have, of course, for future reference. Okay, so kahit nawala na yung crime scene, kahit nabulok or nasira na yung ebidensya, at least we still have the copy. No? We still have the image of original condition, of its original condition. Okay? We can also use photography for discovering and proving. So we cannot deny it eh, that our eyes, of course, meron po siyang limitation lang. May mga bagay na hindi natin nakikita or may mga image or may mga bagay na already beyond our vision. So with the use of photography, okay, it can extend our human vision. Mamaya, we're gonna discuss different types of special photography na ine-emphasize po yung discovering and proving or extension of our human vision with the use of photographs. Okay? We can also have, of course, for court exhibits. Of course, di ba sabi natin kanina, ang mga ebidensyang na photograph sa crime scene, they need to be presented inside the court. Once an evidence or once a photograph now be presented inside the court, they are now considered as exhibits. But take note, a photograph can only be admitted inside the court if it follows our rules on admissibility. So ano ba yung rules on admissibility? Sometimes we call this one as yung ating tinatawag na actions, no? Of admissibility. Okay? When we say that actions are admissibility, an evidence can only be accepted as exhibit or evidence inside the court if pasado siya no, sa tatlong actions natin of admissibility. Ano ba yun? Tatlo yan, no? It should be relevant. It should be material. Okay? And it should be, of course, it should be competent. When we say relevant, mean to say, yung evidensya ba or yung photograph ba has a relevance on the crime under investigation. When we say the word material, can it prove ba the fact, is this evidence can prove ba that a certain fact happened or did not happen? When we say the word competent naman, on the other hand, is it not excluded with the rules of the court? Okay, hindi ba siya pinagbabawal ng batas? If check ka sa tatlong yan, then a certain photograph can now be admitted inside the court and it's now called exhibits. Now, yung exhibits natin, okay, depende yan. Okay, depende po yan siya. Kasi meron pong exhibit na pinipresenta ng mga prosecution at meron din pong exhibit na pinipresenta ng defendant. Okay, sabi sa rule natin dito, evidence presented in court, once accepted, become known as exhibit. Ngayon, kapag ang exhibit, ang kanyang tabbings, no, ang tabbings niya is 1, 2, 3, or naka-numerical, that only means to say that that exhibit ay pagmamayari ng ating defense. On the other hand, kapag ang photograph naman or yung mga exhibit natin ay meron siyang mga tabbings na alphabetical, so ang ibig sabihin niya, pagmamayari yan ng ating prosecution. What else?